Okay, hey there. I am going to talk about the first two financial statements that we'll be learning about in this class. And these are going to be very basic, general, short examples just to get us started. Then throughout the semester, we're going to add and build upon that. So it's really important to know that accounting is a topic that builds on each other. So you have to know these very, very basic things in order to get anything we do in the future. So I'm going to start off with the very first financial statement called the balance sheet. And what does a balance sheet tell us about a company? So a balance sheet tells us what a company has, and we call those assets. And then who has a claim to those assets? So accounting is not really a math class in as much as it is a language class. And that surprises a lot of people. But what that means is you're learning a lot of different terminology and how to speak the language of business. So even if you're not an accounting major, this course is required for all business majors because it's really important for you to speak the language. So before you go and try to learn a concept and how to work a problem, it's very important that you know all the terminology. So look at the end of your chapter or in your Canvas course at the beginning of each module, and I have a list of key terms that you really need to know. So in this one, make sure you know what an asset is. So I like to say it's stuff a company has. That's not super technical, but it gets the point across. Assets are resources a company has that help it earn revenues in the future. Okay, like I said, this is an equation, just like the baby equation you might have learned in sixth grade algebra. If it's got an equal sign in the middle, then everything on the left has to equal everything on the right. And that's important to remember for everything accounting, but specifically in this course, because on an exam or on your homework, you may know some of these amounts, but not all. But because it's an equation, you can solve for the missing amounts by working a regular equation like you would in math. Okay, so some examples of assets. A lot of times I try to use examples of what you have personally, even though obviously this is a business course and we're dealing with companies, but same thing, look around you. What are some assets you have? So I'm here in my home office. Some assets I have in here are the laptop that I'm recording on. I've got textbooks that I use to help me teach. I've got a bookcase, that's an asset. I have a desk right over there. I have a whiteboard on the wall. Companies have vehicles, they have buildings that they operate out of. Those are all stuff the company has, resources. Now, again, the right side of the equation tells you who has a claim to those resources. If a company has liabilities, it means a creditor has a claim to those resources. A creditor is someone who a company or you personally have borrowed from. So if the company went out and borrowed $10,000 from a bank to help get started, it owes the bank $10,000. And then anything left over is the equity the owner has in it, whether that owner's an individual or the company itself or whomever. We will mostly deal with corporations in this class. And so rather than calling it owner's equity then, we call it stockholders or shareholders' equity because they are the owners of a company. But it means the same thing as owner's equity. Okay, here's a basic example related to you as an individual that I hope helps you understand this. Say you just graduated and you want to go buy a new car to celebrate. You got your first job. I don't recommend buying a new car. Buy a good used one. Anywho, another story for another day. You buy a $40,000 Toyota Highlander. What's the asset? That's the Highlander itself. So we don't just write down assets. We write down what type of asset it is. So vehicle, or I could even write SUV or something like that. And I'm going to write $40,000 because that's how much the asset itself is. Now we're going to say, who has a claim to that asset? Well, say you only had $10,000 to put down and you had to borrow the rest from a bank. The liabilities are going to be the $30,000 you had to borrow. The specific type of liability, the name of that account, we're going to call a notes payable. I'm going to abbreviate N/P, note payable. Because we've handed the bank a note saying, hey, I promise I'm going to pay you back with all the terms of that involved. So how much is our owner's equity now? Can you solve this equation if I ask you for owner's equity? Hopefully you said, yeah, it's $10,000. not just because I told you you put down $10,000, but because you know that $40,000 equals 30. Ah, no, it does not. What's missing? Oh, 10,000, 30 plus 10, because you know the equation now. So again, very basic example for that, and we'll dig a lot deeper. We're going to move to the income statement now. Again, that was the balance sheet. This one is your second financial statement we will cover in this course, and it's called an income statement. So notice how the balance sheet does not necessarily tell us if the company's profitable. Is anyone buying anything from the company? Is the company earning any revenue? It just tells us what the company owns and who has a claim to it. The income statement is often called the statement of profitability because it's the one that tells us, are we making any money? That's why we're in business, right? So think of a 10-year-old that's operating a lemonade stand in their neighborhood. The assets are going to be the lemons, the stand itself, the pitcher that they use to pour it with, things like that. But whether or not that lemonade stand makes any money, or what we call a profit, is left up to the income statement. The income statement only has two types of accounts on it, two categories. It has revenues and expenses. So revenues are when the company earns money. So when the lemonade stand sells a cup of lemonade, it has earned some revenue. Expenses are expenses the company has incurred to help earn that revenue. So maybe your lemonade stand is so profitable that you've hired someone and they're working the lemonade stand for you. That's an expense. The sugar that goes in it, the cups, the poster board that you got to make some signs for that. Those are all some expenses you might incur. And I'll just say for a day, you earned $100 in revenue on your lemonade stand and you had $20 in expenses. That means your lemonade stand had a profit of $80. So, which leads me to this last term. You often hear this called net income, but like I said now, you can also hear it called net profit. So here are some more general accounting terms you may not know, or you might have heard, I'm not sure what they mean. Gross and net. So gross is usually the bigger main amount. Most of you guys work, think of your paycheck. Say you're a student worker at UT Tyler and you make $10 an hour and you work 10 hours a week. Your gross pay is 10 times 10, 100 bucks. But your net pay is usually smaller because they've taken out taxes. So net means it has been reduced by some amount, net of some amount. So the gross amount here would be our revenues, but that's why you see that net in front of net income or net profit. We've reduced it by our revenues. So my last point goes back to when I said accounting is the language of business. It's very important to know terminology. And I think one of the things that confuses students sometimes is that there are so many names, just like the English language. There's so many words that mean the same thing. So same here. Notice how we had owner's equity. And I said, oh, but if it's a corporation, you got to call it stockholder's equity. And then down here, net income. Oh, but you might hear it called net profit. So you guys need to know that, because if you're out borrowing money from a bank and they say, did you have a net profit last year? And you only ever learned in class net income. And you go, I don't know what that means. Your banker's going to go, ooh, I don't know if I want to borrow money to you if you don't know what net profit means. So I get it. There's a lot of terms here, but you will be well served to learn those terms before you start the chapter. And I've got them listed in each module in Canvas when you start. They're also in your book, whether you're using an ebook or a hardback, at the end of the chapter. Spend some time on that. Okay, next we're gonna go over the retained earnings video, but I'm gonna make that one separate.